Methodology of earthing design. Please refer this flowchart. It guides you how to design an earthing system. First, you have to go and get the earth resistivity. The earth resistivity will be, you get it through the soil test report. And once you get the earth resistivity, you have to check whether the resistivity is low or high. If the resistivity is from 100 to 400 ohm meter or much low, you can go for normal design. If the resistivity is very high, then you cannot go for normal design. Then you have to go for special design. When I say special design, you have to go for chemical treatment, or you have to go for deep bore earthing, or you have to go for auxiliary earth mat. Now these extra things are required to achieve a low resistance in spite of high resistivity. Now if the resistivity is low, we go to the normal design. What we do, and one more thing is, please check the area. If the area is small, you have to go for special design. Area is big, you can go for the normal design. Now once you come to the normal design, yeah, before that, see, you have to get the plant layout to know the area. So the main inputs are, first get the resistivity, then the plant layout, then the follow the steps. Now coming to the design, normal design. First thing is, please select the conductor material, copper or iron. Now that depends again on the owner's choice. And once you decide on the material, copper or iron, it also depends whether the area is having cathodic protection, then you cannot use copper. So after you decide that, yeah, if the area is having cathodic protection, no, go for yes. Area is not having cathodic protection, you can go for copper. Area is having cathodic protection, you can either go for galvanized iron or galvanized steel. Now, next is, you have to carry out the sizing of the conductor. We are okay. Once you have decided the conductor type, then is you have to do the sizing of the conductor. To size the earthing conductor, the input you need is the fault current. Once you have the fault current, you finish the sizing of the earthing conductor. The next is, you have to determine the resistance of the horizontal conductors. Then you have to calculate, in order to achieve 1 ohm, how many vertical electrodes or earth pits you need. You have to find out that. Let's say I get a total resistance to horizontal conductor as 2 ohms, but I want to achieve 1 ohm, the total grid resistance. So another 1 ohm I have to achieve through the earth pit. Now one pipe electrode at 200 ohm meter soil gives me 55 ohms. So in that case, I will need 55 or 62 earth pits. To do the earth pit along with the horizontal conductor, then I can achieve 1 ohm. Now the next step is, okay, based on the regulation and practice, select the type of something. The source may be TNS or TT or IT system, which I've already explained previously. So you have to go through the regulation and select it. Now finally, what you have to do is, you have to, what is the final outcome? See, what is the input? The input is earth resistivity from the soil test report, plant layout from the mechanical department, the fault current calculation from the power system study group. This is the input. What is the output? Output is, finally, you have to make a layout and you have to prepare a bill of quantity. These are the two outputs. The layout, I've already explained two typical layouts previously. You have to show all the source earthing, generator, transformer, EPS neutral. You have to show the earth pits, earth electrodes. You have to show the horizontal conductors along with the conductor size. And you have to show the earthing of all equipments, electrical equipments. You have to show earthing of all non-electrical equipment like tanks, pipes, pumps, etc. All mechanical package items like compressor, skid, etc., like cranes, you have to show the earthing. And lightning protection, system for buildings or pump house also has to be shown. The electronic earthing system for control room also has to be shown. So that is about the layout. And then finally you have to estimate the total earthing material. Once you have size the earthing conductor and you have the layout, with these two inputs we can estimate the total earthing material, which we call as bill of material or bill of quantity. I will explain that in the next lecture.